So my name is Emmanuel Dumbi. I'm from Congo. I'm in the Democratic Republic of Congo. I've been in Canada since 2009. There is nothing going on in Congo right now because of the war, which started, I believe, it was in 2007. Yeah, I'm one of the luckiest, actually, from Congo. I have been out of my country since 1999. I did work in Africa, in Asia and Europe, luckily. But I did experience war itself because the war started before I left the country. But the most amazing experience for me was the death of my dad. In 2011, it was September 25th, I called my dad. I knew that he was sick. I called him and then I told him that we just bought tickets, my wife and my son, to go and visit him. It was on the 25th, as I said. And on the 26th, I received a phone call telling me that my dad just passed away. I decided to go and bury him. So I traveled to Congo. I buried him. And I went to see the hospital where he was lying down and then everything. There was just nothing in Congo. I believe that if the country was still what it was before I left, my dad could still be alive until today. So my dad, I could say, died because of the war in Congo. Not directly because of he was shot dead, but when you see what is happening now in Congo. And then when I went to the hospital to see where my dad was lying and where he was dead, I had tears. I have one friend who is now a priest in a Catholic church, so he said the mass for the burial of my dad. So I was just talking to him and then asking who he became, because I haven't seen him for years. So he told me that he was working for Caritas. It is an NGO, a Catholic Christian NGO, and he was working with street children, homeless children. So I said, okay, maybe I can have a look, then go and just visit you. So I went there, I see how children are being raped, how children are being deported to Europe and to Asia for prostitution. I had some money in my pocket. Then I gave some donation to what he has been doing. But as you can imagine, he's limited financially. And then I always had the memory of my dad, who taught me to do good things whenever I can. So I said, okay, maybe I can do something. When I came back to Canada, I did study at the University of Calgary. So I approached one of my professors at the University of Calgary. So I told her that I wanted to start a project for street children. And then to be dedicated to the name of my dad. I told her that I wanted to start what I called Gilbert Care Center. Gilbert was the name of my dad. So she did encourage me, and we now have an NGO. But I mean, we're just at the really starting the project now. But this is the project that I want to do because I want my dad not to be forgotten. He's a victim of war. He died because of war. And then I want to honor his name by starting such a project for him. So I have some friends, and then when I see in the office where I work for Child and Family Services, which is kind of lucky also for myself. And when I see some of my colleagues, I talk to them all the time, that so they pass by Starbucks every morning. I tell them that this $7 that you spend every morning, it could make huge change in the life of those children that I saw. So some of my colleagues are on board. They want really to help for this kind of project. We have started what we call the Canadian Congolese Foundation for Children. The first project that we are planning to do is to have that center for street children. Congo is a very rich country in terms of diamond, gold, and cobalt, and all those things. I think has been recognized internationally that the war in Congo, it is because of those things. We don't make arms in Congo. All those arms, they come from Western countries. Why do they sell those arms to them? Just because they want them to be divided so that they can have the opportunity to take whatever they want from the country. You'll hear people saying other reasons why the war is happening. But I believe, and many people who have knowledge about the situation in Congo believe that it is because of those things that the war is happening now. The war started first because, according to what they say, it is because Kabila, who died already, wanted to chase Mobutu from power. So that's the reason why they started. But Kabila, as soon as he was in power, all those Western countries, they came and they signed fabulous contracts for the mining, with the mining companies. And they are making billions and billions, while even, I mean, the people in Congo, they don't even have what you call Advil even for fever. I went to the hospital. There is absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. Of course, we have a lot of things to do over there, but we can't help everybody, so we should start somewhere. Yeah. You can't imagine how lucky you are to even have that chair to sit, to follow instruction from your teachers. I believe that the best solution to war is just starting love one another. If really people love and care about one another, I don't think that we'll have war. It's just love.